welcome to the show for the first time, Chuck Subra of the Tropicana. And he's been everywhere cooking and learning his skill. And now he's here in the tri-state and making some great food. It's so nice to have you on Lifestyle.
Thank you. Great to be here.
What you making for us today?
Today we're going to do a menu item from the Brew Brothers Tap House, which we have at Tropicana Evansville. It is roasted Brussels sprouts with bacon and balsamic glaze.
I love everything you just said. So how does it go?
So we got our skillet ready to go. Throw in a little bit of bacon. A little bit of apple. We use apple smoked bacon here for this.
And why you like just like that flavor?
I love the flavor of apple smoked bacon. It's got a deeper flavor, a nice smokiness to it. And we're just going to sit here and render this out for just a few minutes. We're actually going to use some of the fat from the bacon in the dish. That's what's actually going to coat the Brussels sprouts. And one of the other things we do, we take the Brussels sprouts, we roast them, we salt, we cut them in half, we salt and pepper them, and we toss them with a little bit of bacon fat before we roast them in the oven. And we roast them in the oven for our 20 minutes, anywhere from 20 to 22 minutes. Pull them out, chill them down, and then when we serve the dish, we take them, we heat them up through the dish so they're pre-cooked, and then just go with it from there.
Well, we were talking about how in the past, in my growing up days, you would never see Brussels sprouts on a menu, and now they're on everybody's menu.
They're
everywhere. They're a favorite, aren't they?
Yes. Yes, it's actually kind of they're just like baby cabbages.
I love them. I really do. And this smells like a little bit of heaven. He's cooking on the Samsung. We're in the Samsung kitchen at King's, and this wonderful cooktop right here gives you some control on the heat. You liking it?
I love it.
Yeah, good.
Very nice. Very good. We're going to cook them nice and slow to render all that fat out of that bacon. We'll get it nice and crispy before we go to the next step.
When you're creating dishes for your restaurants over time, how do you come up with the flavor profile you want?
We start with the ingredients. We start with quality ingredients, everything from a really good Brussels sprouts to a really good bacon to a really good onions. And just, I mean, even from the proteins that we put on a dish, we taste everything, and everything's got to match. And then we just start playing from there. But we look for the best ingredients in everything we do, even from the chicken sandwiches that we do in Tap House to the steaks in Kavanaugh's. Everything's got to be a good quality ingredient to start with.
I can tell you're passionate about this.
And if the ingredient's not, if we taste it and it's not there, we go to the next item.
Not happening. Yes. So this combination here with the bacon and the Brussels sprouts and the scallions, and you've got a lot of flavor happening.
Yes, lots of flavor. Definitely just opens up everything. Just when you eat it, you can taste bunches of different things, but they all marry well together. Mm-hmm. Nothing really overpowers the next item.
Can't wait to try this too.
So now that we're getting the bacon rendering out, we'll go ahead and put the onions in and get those sauteing.
Red onions.
I like red onions.
I do too.
You can use white, you can use Spanish, you can use Vidalia. I just prefer red onions.
Got a kick.
Dish.
I like them too. Yes.
Great flavor, great color to the dish as well. So,
you can smell it now.
Yes.
Yep.
And while the bacon's getting nice and crispy, we'll cook the onions down as well so they're not, so you don't have that raw onion flavor to them.
All right, what's next?
Next, we're going to go ahead and add the Brussels sprouts, the pre-roasted Brussels sprouts.
Lovely, lovely. I'm happy. Get all that good bacon fat on there.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Add lots of flavor to it.
Listen to it sizzle.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the thing I want to learn how to do, Chuck.
Oh, yes. You know, the funny thing is, I taught my wife how to do that. I took her out in the backyard with a skillet. with a skillet with rice in it, with raw rice in it. Okay. And that's how you, because the raw rice, you got to try to keep it in the skillet. And she actually learned how to flip it. She cooks eggs over easy. She can cook grilled cheese and flip them. I taught her out in the back when we lived in Louisiana. I taught her out in the backyard, put some raw rice in it, and said, here, nice and gentle, because it teaches you the control that you need.
I'm going to try that when I get home. And now the moment of truth. We're going to plate this beautiful dish. All right, Chuck, fix this up here.
Perfect.
Now, you said at the restaurant you serve it in a bowl like this, but we want to just show it on this lovely plate right here.
So now we can take the Brussels sprouts out of here, nice and crispy. You can smell the bacon, smell the nice caramelized onions there. And
I've got my fork.
And then we've got a little bit of balsamic glaze. This is balsamic reduced down with a little bit of sugar.
I love it.
So it gives a little bit of the vinegar and the balsamic and the sweetness match up very well with the bacon that we have there, and
voila, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Visit this talented man in the many restaurants down at Tropicana, and you can try this wonderful Brussels sprouts dish. Thank you, Chuck. Come back again, will you?
I sure will. Thank you for having me.
We'll be back with more Lifestyles right after this. Brussels sprouts. Oh, baby. That's it.
This portion of Lifestyles is sponsored by King's Great Buys Plus.